Today we're going to show you how to use the Spearman rank order correlation coefficient to correlate two variables. These variables can be in an ordinal scale or even in a ratio or interval scale, especially one that does not happen to be normally distributed. I'm starting out in a Google sheet. I'm particularly interested in two variables, religiosity, and whether or not someone predicts that he or she will eventually have a midlife crisis. Now, both of these variables are ordinally scaled. The subjects answered religiosity by saying that religion was very important, fairly important, or not very important in their lives. They predicted how likely it was to have a future midlife crisis. Very likely, somewhat unlikely, or very unlikely. Now, what we've done is we've coded both of those variables numerically. So for religiosity, we gave a 3 for very important, 2 for fairly important, and 1 for not very important. For the likelihood of a midlife crisis, we gave 4 for very likely, 3 for somewhat likely, 2 somewhat unlikely, and 1 very unlikely. Now, both of these variables are right next to each other, so we can highlight both of their columns simultaneously. We'll go down and include all 50 rows and copy to our clipboard. Then we're going to go to the VassarStats site. We're going to click on Ordinal Data and Rank Order Correlation. And immediately it wants to know how many data pairs do we have. Well, we have 50. Now we're in the Spearman rank order correlation coefficient area. We have the raw data, and it will have to convert those raw data into ranks. Now, we could type in each one of the 100 scores we have, 50 subjects giving us each an X and a Y, but we can just paste everything if we've got them in those two columns. So let's do that. Paste. And now import raw data. And the data now appear over here. We just go down here and click calculate from raw data. And this is what we're going to see. We have our 50 cases, each one giving us 2 bits of data, X and Y. This is the correlation coefficient. Well, it's negative, meaning those with higher religiosity are somewhat less likely to predict a future midlife crisis. But that correlation is very weak. Here's the t-test, the t-score that would come on that. The degrees of freedom is going to be 2 less than our sample size. And let's use the two-tailed p-value. That's not even close to being statistically significant. Well, that's how we use this VassarStats Spearman rank order coefficient site.